Hello and welcome to my channel. This is a series of video which will help you to learn art from the beginner to a pro. Hope you have viewed the first video in this series and practice all the things, because only practice will make you a master. This is the second video in this series. In this video, we will learn about different elements of art and we will also do some tasks to practice them. There are many elements of art. The main elements of art are line, texture, rhythm, perspective, balance, proportion, harmony, shape and forms, space, tones, colors, light and shade, and picture composition. So, we will discuss very precisely one by one point. First coming to the line. What is line? Whenever points are joined with each other, it makes a line. Basically, lines define the shape in a picture and also separate one shape from the other. And every kind of line have different effects. A thin continuous line denotes tenderness and distance, whereas a solid, bold, continuous line denotes stability and proximity. Next is vertical line. Vertical line denotes aspiration, stability, performance, strength and dignity, whereas a horizontal line expresses the feeling of rest in life. It denotes calmness, quietness, peace and balance. And diagonal line expresses excitement, glory, ambitiousness, restlessness and dramatic. Whereas angular type of line denotes struggle, bitterness, agitation, confusion and insecurity. Next, divergent line. This type of line passes in all directions from a point, that is, from the base or from an axis. They show progress, expansion and freedom. Whereas converging line, this line meets at a point and indicates destination. Next, crisscross line. This type of line creates confusion and suspensions. Next, the spiral lines. This line denotes power, movement, development, excitement and progress. Rhythmic lines or wavy lines denotes rhythm, grace, charm and movement. Next, the dotted lines denotes doubt and incompleteness. Then the zigzag line. This type of lines denotes feelings, struggle and depression in life. So, an artist uses all this type of line while drawing anything to express their feeling in a picture. Especially an abstract artist use this more in their paintings. So you also start applying these lines in your painting or drawing to express your feelings. Next, coming to the second point, texture. A structural composition of a surface of any object, that is whether this object is smooth, rough, soft or hard, is called its texture. Artists use different color, medium, techniques to show texture in their painting, to bring optical illusion in their picture. The texture we found in different objects of our nature are called found texture. But when we create texture of our own choice by using different colors, mediums, they are called created texture. Now, you start making different texture in your home on paper, canvas or wood or whatever you find in your home by using color, oil, mixing oil and color, cement, plaster of Paris, whatever you found. The main thing is that you just experiment with many things, whatever you found near you, and make a different texture or invent something new. Next is rhythm. Now, what is rhythm in a painting? As music has rhythm, so painting has also its rhythm. Rhythm in a painting takes our eyes from one part to another, following some arrangement of lines, forms or color. An artist who makes the best use of this rhythm in his painting become more precious and beautiful to look at. Perspective. So perspective is a very very important thing in painting. So I have made a separate video on this topic. Link is given in the description link. Please follow. Next is balance in a painting. The distribution of all the components, subject, object in the painting is called its balance. If we draw many things or very weighty things, heavy things in one side of our drawing sheet and don't draw anything on the other side or draw very few things on the other side, then it becomes informal balance painting. So in this painting you can see that on one side there is a mountain and on another side there is nothing. So it makes one side more heavy than the other, so it is an informal balance painting. But here in the next painting we can see that all the components like the house, grass, trees are equally divided in the both side of the sheet. So we can call it a formal balance painting. So the painting where all the components are equally divided all over the drawing sheet or painting sheet, it can be called as formal balance painting. This balance in a painting should be kept in mind specially while drawing natural scenes, landscapes, sceneries, etc. In art, proportion means measurement of the various components of the picture according to its shape, size and position subjected to our eyes. See, anything which is closer to our eyes, it looks bigger, but when we take it away from our eyes, it becomes smaller. So this proportion, how much it is getting smaller from our eyes by taking away what much distance, this is the proportion in a painting. So while drawing anything, we should keep it in mind at what distance, what will be the size of that object what we are drawing. So while drawing anything, this proportion should be done perfectly in our painting, otherwise we can't make a good picture or painting. Even drawing a human figure and a face have a fixed proportion to draw. Harmony in painting means the gradual flow of the painting. It may be of color, it may be of shades, texture, forms, etc. That is, while doing shading, there will be a gradual flow from the light to the deep. And also, while painting, things which are nearer to our eyes looks brighter, and things which are kept at a distance appears smaller, and their color should be light or diffused. This gives the painting a proper perspective and harmony. Shape and form. The shape and form in art is very easy to understand. You know, it reveals this texture. And while mentioning the form, we refer two types: free form and geometrical form. Apple, ear, nose, all these are free forms, and triangle, square, rectangle, these are called geometrical forms. In the same way, a triangle is a two-dimensional characteristics or two-dimensional form, while a pyramid is a three-dimensional character. I think you know what is two-dimensional and three-dimensional character. If you don't know, please write a comment. We will surely help you. And before learning anything, we should learn to draw the forms of anything so that we can draw anything very easily. And that I will teach you in the upcoming videos. Stay connected by subscribing our channel. Now, the space. Space refers to the area which is used in painting. This can be used in different way with different thoughts. Now the prominent portion of the picture is called the active space and the other portions are called negative space. Now this tone. The tone denotes magnitude of white and black. It is the distribution of light on any object. It denotes a lightness and darkness of an area. Now the colors in painting plays a very vital role. So we have made another video on this topic. Please follow the description link. So light and shade. So this is the most important thing in painting. This is the thing that brings life in the painting. An artist make that place lighter in color or shade, which is nearer to the light or facing the light, and also make the place darker, which is away from the light. With the help of this light and shade, an artist bring the 3D effect in the painting or in the object. The effect of light and shading can be done by using pencil shading, colors, and using different techniques and medium. Picture composition. An artist first think what he will draw or what is the topic of the painting. After that, he put all his idea into his canvas or in the drawing sheet, keeping all the points we have discussed in this video. So in a picture, the main thing or the main focus or the main topic in a painting is called the subject of that painting, and the other things or in the things in the background are called the object of that painting. Like in this painting of Radha and Krishna, you can see that the subject in the painting is Radha and Krishna, whereas the others in the background, like the tree, rivers, and all these things, stones, peacock, all these are the object of the painting. So we will discuss more in our next videos. So please subscribe our channel, like, share, and press the bell icon to get notified of our next video.